me, but I couldn't do it all alone. We, Young Money raised me, grew up out in Baisley, Southside Jamaica, Queens, and it's crazy, cause I'm still hood, Hollywood couldn't change me. Shout out to my haters, sorry that you couldn't faze me. Ain't being cocky, we just vindicated, best believe that when we...
This is my wig. I don't know if you guys, if you follow me on Instagram, you know where it's from. I'm not going to say their name because I'm not being paid to say their name in this video and have you guys buy it. So, I'm just going to pull it. I'm just gonna apply it. Oh shoot, sorry, I was watching it. You see that right there? Just gonna lay it flat.
Did you know the dad in the show and the son, in the first son, they have the same first name in real life?
What? Justin?
Yeah, Justin.
I know. Right. These shows were on when I was little. I watched every single episode. sister. Just gonna brush it out now. I have my sister calling with my nephew. I'm gonna put in a picture of him. You guys can see, but I was just plucking a little more to make it as natural as possible.
Thing, you know what I'm saying? But it is good to take some isopropanol alcohol. This is 50%. And yeah, this is the green one. I just take my little weave rag and I just take a little and I just wipe along the line. If there's any, like, you know, any glue left over that wasn't laid down by lace, especially a lot, because if we do use a lot, it will force the lace to come up. Because this is what I use to remove my lace: water and alcohol to remove the lace, a couple curls, and this is loose wave. I love loose wave. Just gives me that it's not too much, it is not too less. But the lamp is down, and this is off my mom's Coach bag. I took the scarf and never gave it back. Like, wear it like this, like around you, know what I'm saying? Wear it like that. Or it's good for like a headband. I wear like a headband sometimes, or even just to, this is what I use for my frontal. Instead of buying them little frontal caps people be having or whatever, I just do this. Do I have a scrunchie? See? I just do that. Lay my frontal down. Put it up really quick. Just really, really quick. Just so it could be out of the way. And I just take the scarf and leave it wrapped for maybe 10 minutes, because I'm very impatient. I want to see how it came out. So I'm just gonna take it, focus it mainly here. I'm gonna wrap it around like this and just tie it tight. It do sometimes give you a headache from tying it too tight, like if you sleep overnight with it. Because I do that sometimes, sleep overnight with it and leave it like that. I'm gonna go eat my oatmeal.
Time on our hands. I'm gonna do a video of creating an itinerary.
Oh. I'm back and I'm better. And I'm gonna take the wrap off, let it soak in our skin. There it is. It's in there. Scalp. It's in there. Scalp. Let's take this down. And I'm gonna. So okay. So it's time for the styling. We just won by Tai Chi. Oh my god, guys. Look at this. I love living in New York. Deezy, the love. Yeah, just because I love y'all. We gonna be doing baby hair because I love y'all. We gonna do this hair in sections. So, we gonna just do this really quickly. We're not gonna be too fancy today. Not too fancy. I was doing my makeup for y'all, but I am going to the dermatologist today. So, because then he can't really see your skin. Alrighty. So, once again, I'm not gonna say where this hair was from because I am not getting paid, and I'm not gonna be sending y'all a whole bunch of customers, and you ain't gonna be telling me and you ain't paying me or acknowledging me that I sent you. I told you this hair is good. I mind you, this hair was supposed to be like $200, and I ended up paying $300 for it in tax. $50 in tax for some dang hair. I never pay tax for hair ever. And if I did, it's probably maybe like $5. I didn't even know. $40, $50 for some tax. But this hair is very good. I'm not even gonna lie. Minimum shedding. True to length. You know what I'm saying? And it does have a nice natural curl pattern. But I'm still not gonna say where I got this hair from. Because it's in fact, one, name was late. Two, I had to sit there and keep. It said it's gonna give me, what is it called? It's gonna give me a tracking number after 3 to 7 business days. A whole week I have to wait for a free tracking number, and y'all right in Brooklyn. I live in Queens, and y'all right in Brooklyn, and I gotta wait that long. I could see if the shipping took long if I lived like in another state or something. I live in the same state and 10 minutes from y'all. I just didn't request for pickup or whatever because I didn't feel like going, y'all. I don't want y'all to mail it to me. And I'm just like, oh heck. Anyways, but yeah, they took so long. I had to sit there and track the person down. Mind you, it's a man who runs the company. It wasn't a woman. And I had to sit there and track him down in order for him to. Mind you, I'm texting him. He like, oh, I'm going to send. I texted the number that they gave, like, oh, if you have any issues, text his number. So I texted it, and he's like, okay, I'm going to send you the tracking number, and, like, I'm going to send it to you, right? And mind you, I did this right before I went to bed. I went to bed, like, I texted them, like, 8, and then he said he's going to send it around, like, 9 or whatever. And so I went to sleep. I woke up the next morning with nothing, just on red. I was left on red. You know what I'm saying? And I thought that was really like disrespectful. Oh, I'm using my 5-in-1 olive, carrot, avocado, coconut, and jojoba oil scalping hair rejuvenator by Renju Total Beauty. I love this. Hold on. I love this stuff. It smells so good. Like every oil that could possibly grow your hair is in here. It smells great. It smells amazing. I'm just gonna put it in my hair just to like soften it. But anyways, yeah. So, and then I had to text them on Instagram because look, oh, it just made the curls come out. I texted them on Instagram. I had to, because he didn't even text me back. So I had to go on Instagram like, excuse me, I still didn't get no type of tracking number. So like he's like, and then next thing you know, he's like, oh, it should be at your email, something like that, he said. So I checked my email, it's there, and I have to keep asking for it. Like if I sat here and paid $300 for your hair, and it was supposed to be only like 2 something, and then you have the nerve to get like some type of attitude. Like you the one who didn't get me the tracking number. You was been supposed to. I literally counted. I was like, wait, why the tracking number take so long? And then I realized it said, oh, through 3 to 7 business days, whatever, 4-1. So it's like, first of all, that means you don't have enough people. Why are people gotta wait that long to know where their hair is and they spent a whole bunch of money on it? Why we gotta wait that long? Like, I get it. I just ordered it on a Friday. But to find out they don't, like, do orders on Saturdays or something like that, they don't be in business or whatever on that day. Like, and it's sad because the hair is good, but I don't think I would ever buy from them again just because of that reason. That reason right there. They're like, I feel like they're unprofessional because, like, why do I have to track you down? And I tried to be nice, show them a little love on Instagram despite the reasons because nobody's perfect. And they didn't even want to acknowledge me that I showed them love. I was like, hair is by at JD Bundles because people always ask where I get my hair from, especially this one. Everybody was asking where I got it from. Even told my sisters where it's from, but I told them do not buy from them because the service is horrible. But yeah, I just did not like how he handled that whole entire situation. And I don't know if it's because he a guy, because a girl when she handled Bella, like I got hair from at Queen K Hair before for my birthday hair, and it was so long. I'm gonna put a picture in of you guys so you guys can see which birthday hair I'm talking about. And she
I didn't get no, her assistant actually was the one handling it because she do get a lot of orders. So she had an assistant, and the assistant was supposed to give me the tracking number, all that. The assistant didn't. So I'm texting like, I still didn't get nothing. And she's like, and she's a girl, of course. So she understand the frustration of not getting your hair. So she was like, oh my God, I'm so sorry. Like, I just fired my assistant because of this, because she did not do what she was supposed to do. So she fired the assistant and everything just because I was unhappy. You know what I'm saying? And that's good. It's not good the assistant got fired, but she did something to show that she do care about her customers and what they and how they're feeling about her company. So she did something about it, and she personally had her friend drop off the hair to my house, and I didn't have to pay nothing for drop off. I shouldn't have to because I ordered it to be delivered, but she literally the assistant never sent it out. The assistant never sent out my hair. So she literally took the hair that was in her shop. She took the hair that was there in her shop, because she do sell bundles in her shop, but I requested for it to be delivered and not to go pick it up. And her friend literally took care from her shop, the front one, all that out, ordered the whole 40 inches, and she brought it to my door herself. The friend did what she was supposed to, but she I think she was doing something, so she made sure the friend dropped it off herself, you know, instead of waiting for like a postman or whatever. And I thought that right there was like, that was professional. That was what a real boss would do. Because I would do the same thing. Because the assistant didn't even send out what she was supposed to. That's why I didn't even get it. And it's been like 2 weeks since I got my my hair. I mean, since I ordered it, and I still didn't have it. Mind you, she's in Brooklyn too. The Queen K hair. That's in Brooklyn. And it took me like 2 weeks to get it. But the difference is how she went about it. And he just like nonchalant about it. You know what I'm saying? I guess because he has the eye. I don't know. And I guess because I'm not a big person, that he don't care if I'm unhappy or not, because I'm not celebrity or whatever. But yeah, I'm not going too crazy with the curls. You know what I'm saying? Just gonna do a little something. I just want it to look nice. I will be doing what's it called? My middle part. I know middle parts is my thing. Just gonna, and then I'm just gonna get front. I'm not trying to make this some type of big thing, but I'm just gonna show you guys how I style it. Remember, always comb from the bottom with your weave. And this hair does minimum shedding. The Queen K hair I had before, it was very sheddy, like very, and you had to like brush it, I guess, because it wasn't her mink bundles, it was her regular Brazilian hair bundle. But I never had bundles that stick together so much. Like, it was straight, and like if I was walking, like I would just brush it and I was walking, I'll go like this, like it would stick together like as if it was synthetic. It was true to length though, and then it started shedding so much. It went from 40 inches to, I would say, like 26. It's so short. It's to my back now. Like, the wig does not do well with time. Let me show you. And I bleached it blonde. I don't know if it's the blonde that made it look that way, but I tried to rejuvenate this wig so much. Look how short this was. This is. And this was a 40-inch wig. This is not 40 inches whatsoever. This is probably, like, 26. And look at it. This is how it sticks together. That's how it was when I first bought it. It would stick together just like this, and I had to keep brushing it because people were like, oh, should I brush it, brush it, brush it? Like, it was so long and so nice in the beginning, but it's like, and look at this, it just got short. Like, I don't know how. I literally wash this wig all the time, and this is what happened to it. Why, I don't know. I tried to rejuvenate this wig. I tried to do so much stuff to get it back, to like make it do something, and it just wasn't working out. So I was just like, you know what, this wig gotta go. And I just haven't used it. I didn't want to throw it out. I want to try to see if I could like do something to it, like I did to my other wig, this curly wig should I be wearing this one. So that one started acting up, but I got it to like a good place. But yeah, the hair, where I got this hair from, Their hair is really good. I'm not even gonna lie. It's really nice. Doesn't shed. Doesn't stick together or none of that. And the wave pattern is amazing. But I don't think I will buy from it. One, because of the tax issue. Two, yeah, the tax. And then it's so quick when it says to buy. Like, for example, it was like at two, I think it was at 210. And then it was like, okay to, and you know, click pay. You enter your card information. Next thing you know, what you see is tax pop up, $50, and then the screen shuts off that you paid. Like, it didn't do that before. But as soon as you click pay, it shows up how much the tax is, and then it's like a scam. Like, cause if they know that if you seen the tax beforehand, you would have not paid for it. You would have left it. So they like do it once you click the pay button, cause that's what it did to me. And then it was like, and I click pay with my, cause I pay with PayPal, so I get a receipt. And then it was like, tax $50, $60. I'm like, wait, hold on. But you can't cancel it, cause you paid it already. And it clearly states in the thing, no refunds under any circumstances. So I can't even get, you can't even get your money back if you say, hey, I didn't want to pay no $60 tax on some weave. And then you can do about it, cause it clearly states no refunds for any type of reason. And it's like, you feel like you just got. Cause it don't say on the screen before about this tax. It don't say nothing about that. Cause I never paid tax on here before, ever. I just paid like the shipping and handling. That's like maybe like $10 the most. And that was it. That's all I really ever paid. Let me turn this heat up on this. Cause their hair was good, it's just their customer service is horrible, and I mean horrible. And basically you just keep doing the same thing for all their hair. But how are y'all doing? Just leave it on for a few seconds and then just let it drop. That's what I do. Just gonna curl this up back here. And just keep curling. I'll be back when I'm done, and I'm gonna show you guys how to do it. I'm just gonna, I did my edges over to my liking, and I'm just gonna use this, lay them down for like 5 minutes, and then I'll be back. Okay guys, this is the finished look. I lied, let me see. Okay, this is the finished look. You guys can go to the corner, and I'll see you in the next video. Wait. Subscribe. Okay?